loves, welcome back to my channel. Welcome if this is your first time here. My name is Day, and if you like videos like this one, go ahead and subscribe and join the lovely family. Stick around, I would love to have you guys here. And for those of you who have been here, thank you guys so much for coming back to see me. So in today's video, we are going to be chatting about a topic I get asked about quite a lot, like quite a lot. Today we're gonna be discussing reasons why your hair is not locking. Reasons why it won't lock as fast as you are expecting it to lock. Everyone's hair is different, guys. Like, there are hundreds and thousands of us out there trying to lock our hair. So me being a person that has not seen everyone's hair, it's not much I can do to really specifically explain your hair's locking process. I don't know about your hair's history. I don't know what you've done to your hair in the past. So it's difficult for me to speak on everyone, but I thought that it would help out to give some general things as to why, you know, your hair may not be locking as fast as you think it should. I believe that anyone who has kinky hair, somewhat of kinky hair, or who is of African descent, your hair coils up. I think that anyone's hair will lock eventually if they just let it be. That's just my opinion. So let me say that beforehand. I don't have any tips and tricks as to how to make your hair lock super fast, because I really think that overall it just takes time. But you know, here are some of my thoughts and ideas. So the first reason why your hair is not locking quickly is the obvious. You probably have a loose hair texture. A lot of times people come to me and ask, why isn't my hair locking as fast as yours did? I have very, very coarse hair. I have 4C hair. So, you know, my hair, it clings together very quickly. It's just like the nature of my hair. So if you have very loose curls or coils, like your hair is in its natural state and the curls are very loose and open, it's gonna take a little bit of time before your hair, you know, binds together, just because the hair is loose. So some people as well think that because they have thick hair, you know, that their hair is like 4C or very, very kinky, and that's not the case. You can have very soft, you know, a little bit more on the kinky side hair, but your curls are still very loose. A lot of people say in the comments on my videos, like, my hair isn't locking and it's been 4 months. Like, guys, 4 months is not a long time. Like, my hair, it's been a year, and there are some ends on my hair that still, I can see the two-strand twist pattern. I can feel some of them too. The two-strand twist pattern is still there because it takes a long time. You're asking your hair to kind of come together and combine as one. It takes a long time. Your hair is not gonna lock in 2 months. It's not gonna lock in 4 months. Sometimes you will not even see it locking for sometimes over a year. There are some of us whose hair does not lock for a year. So just leave it, let it be. If you think that, you know, there are some other things that would ease your mind. Like, I know we had a big video about instant locks and things like that, but if you feel like the only way for you to stick in the journey is to get instant locks, then, you know, do that, you know? But understand that your hair will lock if you leave it alone. I've seen people with the loosest, curliest, like, very kind of like mixed texture kind of hair, very, very loose curls. I've seen it with my own eyes, and they let their hair be, and it took a long time, but it did lock eventually, and it was beautiful when it did. So understand that sometimes it just takes time, and that is just your hair texture. Another reason why your hair may not be locking as quickly as you would like could be a result of the manipulation. So I always tell people, the less you touch your hair, the better. A lot of people, when they get locks, they kind of become like obsessed with their hair, like obsessed. I know, because I've been there before. Like, obsessed, they're constantly touching it, pulling at the end, seeing if something can bud, seeing if you've seen any budding, just doing all this. Like, just leave your hair alone, because you're honestly reversing the process when you're messing with it all day. And a lot of times we deal with unraveling in the beginning of the journey, and I always tell people that's perfectly normal. And you should retwist your hair up, but sometimes you just have to leave it alone when it's unraveling, even sometimes, instead of like every day, like touching it, manipulating it, and trying to like twist it around and doing all this. Like, just let it sit, like, leave it alone, because locking takes like time. It's a process. Sometimes it's nothing you can do. You just gotta sit there. I also think that washing your hair actually helps your hair to lock a lot faster. I know a lot of people think still to this day that they shouldn't wash their locks, that, you know, washing it will kind of separate the hair, but there are ways around that. You could very well get a little hair net cap and put the hair net over top of your starter locks and wash your hair that way, if you feel like you can get your scalp clean. You can also bind your locks, which is a method that a lot of people use. They may like take a rubber band or like some type of like method of tying their hair together like this and then washing the roots. I would be very gentle when washing starter locks. You can't really wash your hair the same way that you would wash, like, you know, an afro. Like, you can't be combing through it and like scrubbing it, you know, doing all that stuff to it. But just make sure your scalp is clean. Maybe like just take the palms of your hands or the tips of your fingers and wash that way, being very gentle, and let it dry. And anything that is unraveling after you wash it, maybe retwist it back in that moment. But after that, kind of just let it be. Those are my recommendations. I also went through a time where I was combining my locks and I would try to twist up some of my locks and they would unravel. So I know what that is like as well. And I had to just let my hair sit, and that took a long time as well, watching my hair unravel. But eventually it did lock. It just takes a long time. Like, the locking process is not something that happens overnight. Like, another reason why your hair may not be locking as quickly as you want it to be could also be a result of some of the things that you did to your hair before you started your locking process. So I know a lot of people have tried to lock their hair on top of hair that is, how can I say, damaged, texturized. Some people ask me, can they lock their hair with a perm? I personally have not seen it, but the straighter your hair is, of course, the harder it's gonna be for it to lock. And of course, you know, those damaged ends pretty much fall off eventually. So I would pay attention to maybe the steps that you took to prepare your hair for locking. So if you have not locked your hair yet, the best thing you can do is just let your afro grow out. Get really like as kinky as it wants to be. Of course, we know as well that we should not be using products like conditioner, especially in the beginning. I would not recommend it. I know there's a lot of controversy about that, and I'm not here to tell anybody what to do. So if you feel like you need to do that, then absolutely. But the conditioner is what's gonna loosen up your hair, and we want the opposite. We want our hair to kind of bind together. So that's also another thing that you can look out for. I think all in all, what you need is patience. What you need is time, okay? And what you need to do is just leave your hair alone, because like I said, I've seen the loosest of curls lock eventually. And I think that everybody's hair will do that in its own time. So those are my things. That's the best advice that I could give myself. I haven't seen everyone's hair, but I've seen quite a bit of lock stories. And I think that that's mainly the case. So give yourself at least a year before you say my hair isn't locking. And then after a year, if your hair isn't locking, then maybe we could talk about some other methods. But definitely at least give it a year, in my opinion. But yeah, thank you guys so much for joining me. Please drop your comments down below. I would love to hear you guys, your comments. Drop down below also how long it took for your hair to lock, so that other people can see, you know, that the time frames all vary a lot through our community in terms of like locking. So thank you all so much. I appreciate you, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye.